Good evening. In this session, I am going to deal with research methodology and medical statistics. How to prepare this entire research and stats within a 5 days of duration. First of all, before going into the syllabus, you have to know how to read and what to read this research methodology and stats. Keep it in your mind that you must not neglect this research because it is only for 50 marks and there will be nothing like practical and viva examination for this paper. Okay, so that you have to write each and every question which is asked in the exam paper. Okay, you must not leave a question, because if you leave a question a short or else an essay means you will lose your marks among those short 50 marks there itself. So you have to present each and every answer whatever you know regarding that topic, okay? And this will be for 50 marks and there will be no practical and viva point of view. So you have to concentrate while you reading also, because 1 or 2 marks may vary if you lose your concentration while reading. It will be much burden on you. So concentrate on your reading, how to understand what you read. Understand what you are reading. There is nothing in it to by heart and to present in an examination. Whatever you are writing in your examination, that must be read and understand by you. That's enough for this paper. Okay, first of all, I'll deal you what to read in the research and stats paper and how to present in an examination. Brief historical and scientific evidences of research in Ayurvedic studies and contemporary medicine. In this topic, you have to read what is research, and all you come through that research is to discover the new facts and verifying the old ones by scientific study of a subject. Okay, research is to discover new facts, to know new facts and to verify old science, but by a scientific study. Okay, this is the definition. In the research, R is for rethinking, E is for experimental method, S is for survey, E for evaluation, A for aptitude, R for recognition, C for current affairs, and H for help or head. Okay, this you have to learn regarding this research topic. And coming to the etymology, definition and synonyms, you have to know what are the synonyms. Anveshana, Gaveshana, Prayeshana, Anusandhana and Shodha. These were the synonyms of this research. Okay, regarding this, it will be enough. And coming to the etymology, the word research is derived from 2 French words. C-H-E-R-C-H-E, Cherche means to look for, Recherche means again, once more, to look after. This is the etymology, definition and synonyms. We have completed this. If you understand this, you can elaborate in your exam point of view. Next, evidences of this research. Regarding this topic, you have to know according to Ayurveda Paribhasha and Chatushpada Siddhanta, you have to know Bishek, Dravya, Upastata and Rogi were considered as Chikitsa. Chatushpada and 3 Sutra, Hetulinga, Aushadha, 3 Danda, Sattvatma, Sharira and 3 Nishana, Praneshana, Dhanishana and Paralokeshana and about the Panchakarma. Next, while coming to Sushruta Samhita, Yantra were 10, Shastra were 20, Yogya Sutriya and 60 Vrana Chikitsa. Okay, and Dhakta Vrana Chikitsa, Ashtavida Shastra Karma and Mrita Samshodhana were dealt by Sushruta Acharya. According to Ashtanga Hridaya, Shukra, Artava, Varnana and Agada Tantra were dealt. And you all know that Ashtanga Ayurveda. You all can write all these headings in the evidences of research in Ayurveda. Next, scope, need, utility and importance. In this heading, you can elaborate the Dinacharya, Ratricharya, Rutucharya, Sadvritta Palana, Rasayana, Vajikarana. Okay, all these methods you can elaborate in this scope of research in Ayurveda. What I have said, Dhinacharya, Ratricharya, Rutucharya, Sadvritta Palana and what is the need of this? Following this Dhinacharya and all, you have to write in this need and scope of Ayurveda, research in Ayurveda. Next, the need of research in Ayurveda is the main purpose is what? To discover an answer to a question, to discover a new things and to discover a new facts. Okay, this will be the need of research in Ayurveda. While coming to importance of research in Ayurveda, you can elaborate experiments and experiences. Okay, Ashwagandha is for Balakarya. For this experimentation methods, first we'll deal with the practical method. If three mouses were taken and we are giving feed to them, first mouse is fed with Phala Ahara. I'll give you a chart, a diagrammatic form, then it will be easy for you to understand. Okay, I have given you here, first mouse is fed with Phala Ahara and second mouse is fed with Phala Ahara along with Ashwagandha. And third mouse is fed with Palahara and some other food. Okay, in this, if we observe the rate of growth, means the second mouse is faster in growth rather than the other two. This we can identify. By this, we can conclude that Ashwagandha helps in growth. Okay, next. This completes the importance of research in our Ayurveda. You can elaborate this example, and regarding the Amlaki Rasayana and Guruji Sattva, you can write. Amlaki Rasayana can be taken by every individual for Rasayana purpose. It promotes the benefits of Rasayana. Regarding the benefits of Rasayana, verify our description box. I'll give you the Rasayana benefits, shloka and explanation. Next, types of research. In this types of research, you have to know what is pure research, what is qualitative research and what is quantitative research and all. Okay. You have to know the basic differences between this qualitative and quantitative research also. Okay. Type of data. In the qualitative research, the type will be in the form of word. In quantitative, it is numerical form. Here, magnitude in qualitative is no magnitude, and for quantitative there will be a magnitude. Base, quality, and in quantitative is for measurement. Variable is single frequency and two characteristic frequencies were seen in quantitative. And nature, subjective in qualitative and objective in quantitative. Use, while coming to uses, no statistics for analysis. Okay, here require statistics for a quantitative. This completes the major differences between the qualitative and quantitative researches. While coming to Pramana, you all know that Pramana, Pratyaksha, Anumana, Aptopadesha, Yukti and all. Okay, I'll deal a separate class regarding this Pramana. You have to know all these headings while attempting the Pramana answer about the Pratyaksha, Anumana, Aptopadesha and Yukti also. Okay, you have to cover this. 1, 2, 3. These topics you have to cover in day 1 schedule. And 4, 5, 6. You have to cover this in day 2 schedule. And in day 3, ethics and evidence-based medicine and importance of IT in data mining. And in the day 4, you have to read portals, PubMed and all. PubMed is the most important one, which is asked for most of the examinations for a short note. So you have to learn without skipping this PubMed. Okay. This completes the basic and important things regarding this research topic in Ayurveda. Okay, I'll give you a separate class regarding the research, what is research and what is evidence-based medicine, what is data mining, what are pramana and all, along with the shlokas and references. First of all, you go through this video for learning and knowing the basic things, how to attempt if it is asked in the examination. This video will be helpful for you. If it is asked, means research process, I have dealt an elaborated lecture for essay answer regarding this research process. I'll give you the video link in the description. You can go through that for research process. Regarding those pramana and all, I'll make you to learn in an easy format in coming lectures. Don't neglect the portals, because most of the times any one portal will be asked for examination point of view. Regarding this Anumana and all, you all have go through in Padartha Vijnana in your first year. So, however, you can write somehow in your examination. So try to learn the new things, that is evidence-based medicine, portals, concepts and importance of ethics in research. Okay, all this you have to learn, and research process is the basic essay answer which is asked most of the times in our examination. So try to learn that. In the next class, I'll give you a class regarding the evidence-based medicine, and for the statistics also, I'll make you to know what have to write if it is asked in an examination. The basic idea I'll give you in the next video. So subscribe, like and comment in the video section if you need any particular topic. Thank you.